Hi, I'm Lucy Ravitch from kidsmathteacher.com, where we're turning everyday experiences into hands-on math activities. Yay! Today for Math Activity Thursday, we're going to be making popcorn. Here's just a few ways you might turn kernels or microwavable popcorn into a hands-on math activity. For those of you who have a popcorn maker at home, you can do a lot of different experiments. After you've measured out your popcorn, you can count and see how many have actually popped and see that percentage. Okay, we're gonna get to popping this. Okay, they're popping. Sometimes it's fun to just count and see how long it actually takes for the popcorn. The smell tastes so good, you want it to hurry up and just finish. If we cook it longer, would more kernels pop? How many did pop? Do we want to count them or measure them? What's the approximate percentage of corn that popped? Then you can see how many actually didn't pop. Out of this much popcorn, as I searched through, there are a few kernels here. 2, 3. Out of all these kernels, 5 of them didn't pop. You might enjoy popping popcorn so much you try several experiments and see if you get the same results each time. If you're using microwavable popcorn, there's still a few ways you can turn this into a math activity. Do a countdown as the microwave does its countdown. Listen for the pops and count between them. If it gets between 3 seconds of each pop, your popcorn may be done early. After your popcorn is finished, dump out the popcorn into a bigger bowl. How many kernels didn't pop? How many did? No matter which way you popped your popcorn, it's time to share it. How will you share your popcorn? Will you be sharing it equally or approximately? How will you divvy out that popcorn? If I need to share it with 2 other people, there are a few ways I can do it to make sure it's equal. I can take it piece by piece, take it by the handful, or even weigh it to make sure it's equal. Lastly, you can time yourself eating popcorn. Are you going to be taking your time eating your popcorn? Will you make a game out of it and see your average of catching the popcorn in your mouth? 3, yay! Or are you a fast popcorn eater? Then, if you timed yourself eating the popcorn, see if you can figure out how much popcorn you consume per minute or per second. Let us know in the comments below how your popcorn activity went. For more math activities and elementary products you can use with your kids, share, subscribe, and join us each week. Thanks for watching.